Hello, everyone. Am I audible and visible? Okay, so I'll start. Oops. Maybe this month only I'll take a week in which I will cover the oops. Okay, so at that time I'll do that. Right now we are covering DSA, which is very, very important as well. Okay, so oops also I'll take. No worries, I'll definitely take it. So just keep going with me. Okay, so. Let me just start in a while. Let's wait for 2 more minutes and we'll start, okay? So till then, anybody has any questions, you can ask me. Then we'll start in 2 minutes, right? Any questions? Any more questions you have? सर आई एम ई सी ई मैं इसी में हूँ. फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर में मुझे कितना टाइम कोडिंग में देना चाहिए डेली? सी इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो इन द कोडिंग फील्ड एंड यू आर इन फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर सो यू हैव इक्वल टाइम एज एनीबडी इन आई टी और सी एस दैट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम सो यू कैन डेफिनेटली स्टार्ट एंड जस्ट कीप गोइंग विद इट ओके डोंट स्टॉप लाइक डोंट लूज प्रैक्टिस एट एनी टाइम जस्ट कीप गोइंग एंड आई से ऑन द डेली बेसिस जस्ट एटलीस्ट गिव 3 to 4 hours बिकॉज प्रैक्टिसिंग डी एस ए विल टेक अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम राइट सो जस्ट डू दैट That will be very essential because people say that like people or in the colleges as well some companies come they only want that they want to hire from CS and IT only okay so you may be able you may not be able to sit on in those placements but sometimes like off campus you can sit in any placement in any company's rounds you can sit in that so just keep doing it not a worry okay and if you are in a college where you can sit in the placements as well EC students can sit so that's very good you will be able to crack it if you start now just keep going so see in core java it is just you will get to know about how to actually code in java like basic things all the basic things in advanced java what happens is there is like other things as well like you can say applets servlets these types of things comes up in advanced java so that is not needed in your DSA like DSA part that is not needed but that is needed if you are going in a Java field only like if you want to become a Java developer or those types of things right okay so let me start okay so the people who have joined for the first time my name is Rahul Singla I am SD1 at Innovacer I was ex-mentor and SD at Geeks for Geeks I mentored a lot of students in major IITs NITs I cracked companies like Grofer Swiggy And the subjects that I'm taking here are Core Java, Oops in Java, DSA in Java, and after that we will see comparative programming in Java as well, right? Now, coming to career as a developer subscription, what is this subscription? So this subscription consists of a lot of interesting shows. Okay, what types of shows I'm talking about? The shows are written here like placement in top product and service based companies, beating the odds to get good placement, live problem solving sessions, over the weekend projects, and a lot more other. There will be mock interviews as well like mentor will be there student will be there they will be they will actually show you how actual interviews goes right how actual interviews goes they will show you that and also when which companies are hiring and also like how to become good at like your rank, to improve your rank at CodeChef. These types of shows are going on here. And if you are a developer or you are in a field of becoming a developer, I think these things are also very important, just other than your placements, right? Not other than your DSA or competitive programming skills. Okay. So this is just for 999 for 1 year. And if you use my code rsingler10, you will get it for 10% off, right? So you can get it for 899 only. Okay. Now moving on. So we have the CodeChef Apprentice. This is one of the shows in Career as a Developer subscription. So it is live every Saturday afternoon at 2 p.m. It has started on 14th August. Sai Avinash, who is SD at Google and 7 star at CodeChef, he is taking these shows, and in which what he is telling you is that how to become 7 star at CodeChef, because he himself is a 7 star. So he will tell you the journey, what actually is needed to become a 7 star at CodeChef. All these things will be covered. Okay. So if you guys are interested in all these things, you want to become a competitive programmer, I think these shows are very, very important. And these are all covered in Career as a Developer subscription, which is just for 999 for the whole year. Okay. And if you use my code, it will be 899 for the whole year. Right. So you can buy it if you want. So now coming to the Telegram channel that we have. So if you want any updates, you have any queries, you can ask in this channel. So you guys can go and just join this, because all the courses coming up, all the previous courses, all the shows coming on Pro Plus, everything will be shown to you on this only, right? So just do that. And also please like, share and subscribe, because everybody should be able to get these shows, like these classes that we are taking here. So if you guys want, your friends can also join. Anybody who is needed, who needs these classes, can join. And also if you like it, just like and share as well, right? So let's move forward. And what is our agenda for today? So what we are going to do is, we are going to do a lot of questions on arrays today, right? A lot of questions on arrays we will do today. Okay, so let's start without wasting any more time. Let's start. Right. So there is some question, how to be good at recursion. What is the difference between, yeah, see, how to be good at recursion. I have already taken 3 sessions on recursion. Okay. Those were the previous week session. So if you want, you can watch them, because I have covered each basic, from very basic, I have covered that, and that will actually help you becoming good at recursion, because those are very good lectures. And if you start from very basic, keep doing the questions the way I have shown there, so you guys will be able to do it very well, right? So just go and watch that, right? So now coming to some questions that we are going to do today, right? We left here in the previous class. We have studied about a lot of things. We have studied about how recursion work with functions, how it actually, like, not recursion, sorry, arrays work with functions. And also we have seen that how actually what arrays are, how they are printed, how we go on each element of array and do all those things, every operation that we can do on array, we have seen that. Now what we are going to do is, we will build our logic around arrays questions, right? We will build our logics, and we'll do a lot of questions around it. So let's start. Okay, so in the previous class, in the end, I gave you a question, if you guys remember. So anybody remember the question that I gave you in the previous class? Anybody who remember? See, I remember it. So if you guys remember it, just let me know. So let me tell you, the question was, you are given with an array, okay? So let me write it here. What we have to do is, you are given with an array, okay? And in this array, you are given with some elements. Let's say 2, 3, 5, 7, 8, right? And let's say the name of the array is AR. And what you have to do is, you have to tell me that if this array is sorted or not. Sorted means, all the elements should be in increasing order, right? So this array is sorted, right? So the answer should be yes. The Yes, okay. If the array is not sorted, the answer should be no. Right? So if the array is like this, let's say 2, 5, then we have 3, then we have 8. Okay, so in this case, all the elements are not increasing. See, increasing means that the previous element should be less than the current element. If this is the current element, this element should be greater than the previous element. Okay, so in this way, every element will be in increasing order. So this is what we have to do, and this is the answer should be no here, right? So what I can do is, so I am new. Can you please give me a quick explanation how to declare array in Java and Access? Okay, declare. Yeah, I'll show you when I'll go into the question. I'll show you that. Okay. So this is an array. Okay. So what you have to do is, your agenda is, you have to write a function. First of all, you have to write a function. Okay. In those in that function, you will pass this array. Okay. And that function will give you either true or false on the basis of that, if this array is sorted or not. Okay. This is what you have to do. If this is array, this array is sorted, you have to return true. Otherwise, you have to return false. This is what you have to do. Right. So yeah, we have done this in the recursion video, but right now what we will do is, we will do it with the help of loops only. Okay, not to the recursion part. We will do it with the help of loops. Right. So now I hope the question is clear, that the array should be, if it is in increasing order, you have to return true. Otherwise, you have to return false. Okay, this is what you have to do. Now, what should be the logic? Like, what should be the logic? It is very, very easy, right? The logic is just in front of us. So what you have to do is, let me tell you what we have to do. Let's say this is the array we have. And what we will do is, we will make a function. We will pass this array to that. And what the logic we will take, like what logic we should apply here. The logic should be very simple, that we will go on each element. Let's say I start from here. I will check, these are the indexes 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I will check that if this element is greater than the previous element, then till now it is in sorted order. Okay, that means till here, till this array, we are in sorted order if this first index element is greater than the previous element. Right? Then what I will do is, I will move further. Let's say this is some I pointer I am using. So I will move forward, and this I will point at second index element. Okay. Now I will check if this element is greater than the previous element. Yes, it is greater than the previous element, then it is okay. Yeah, we will move forward. Okay. Now I will point here. So I is pointing at the third index now. So if this element is greater than the previous element, yes, it is greater. So it is sorted till here. Now I will, my eye will move to the next element. I will see that if this 8 is greater than the previous element, yes, it is greater. So that means my whole array is in increasing order, right? My whole array is in increasing order if I use this case, right? But let's say, how we will find that if array is not in sorted order? Okay, that is the case. We want to find the false case as well. So let's say I am taking an unsorted array. Okay, unsorted array I am taking 2, 5, 3, 8 and 7. Let's say this is the array we have, and these are the indexes. So what same logic I will use, that if this element, which is on the first index, if it is greater than the previous element, then we will move forward. Yeah, it is greater than the previous element, 5 is greater than 2, so we will move forward. Okay, my I pointer will now point here. Now I will check that if 3 is greater than 5. No, it is not greater than 5. So what will happen in this case is, here only we have to return false. Okay, here only we have to return false. Right, because if any element, like if in any pair there is like the current element is smaller than the previous element, that means if this is the current element, if it is greater than the previous smaller than the previous element, then this is definitely, this array is not in sorted order if we find even one pair, right? So this is the logic we are going to use here. So we will check if the whole array just goes like this, that if the current element is greater than the previous, current element is greater than the previous, if this happens in the whole array, then we will return true. Otherwise, anywhere I find like this, that the current element is smaller than the previous element, then I will return false. Okay, this is the logic we are going to use here. I hope logic is clear. Let's write the code for this now. Okay, let's write the code, and then we will dry run it so that we will get the clear view how actually it is working, right? So let's make a function. First of all, let's make a function public static void, and let's say function is sorted, that if the array is sorted or not, I am making that function. So int of arr I am making here, right? So now what I am going to do is I am going to make int, not int, see, we already have an array. Now what I have to check is I will go on each element of the array. Okay, for int I equal to 1. Why I am starting from 1? Because how I am, logic I am using here is that if I am at the current element, let's say I am at the first index, I will check that if it is greater than the previous element, right? I will use this logic. So I am starting from the first index, right? Because if I start from 0 and I check that for the previous element, then it will give me array out of bound exception, that minus 1 index cannot be accessed, right? Because we start from 0. So if I, that's why I'm starting from 1. Okay, so now let's move forward. And if int I equal to 1, I should be less than arr.length, right? We have to go till last element and I plus plus. Okay, now what I will do is if I find even one pair which is not following the rule, that means current element is less than the previous element. Okay, so if current element, let's say we have this array, okay, let's write it here 2 5 3 1. Okay, so this is the case. If this is the case, what will happen is if I am at this element, right, if I am, my I is at this element, if I find it that this element is smaller than the previous element, because for array to be sorted all the elements should be in increasing order, but if I find it like this, that if this ith element is smaller than the previous element, at that moment only I will return false, that this array is not sorted. So that false condition I will write here. If arr, let's say name of the array is arr, arr of I is smaller than arr of I minus 1. Okay, I minus 1. If this is the case, here only I will return false. Okay, here only I will return false. So this will be my false statement. Sorry, I have to write boolean here. If I am returning something, then I will write boolean here. Okay, now what I have to do is, if it passes, let's say if it never goes into false into this if statement, if it never goes into this if statement, that means if it is never let's say all are in increasing order, so let's say 2 3 4 5 is there, so it will never go, if I am at any index I, so it will never go into this if statement, right? If it will never go inside this if part, so in that case, if it never goes inside this if part, we have to return true, right? We have to return true here, right? So this is how it is working. So let me dry run it for you guys for once. Let's say we have this array 2 3 5 6. Okay, let's dry run it. This is our array 0 1 2 3. So let's say my I starts from 1. My I will start from here. So now what will happen? I will go inside. Okay, let's write here if I is equal to 1. Okay, so in this case arr of I will be arr of 1, that means 3. If 3 is less than arr of I minus 1, I minus 1 is 0, right? Because if I is 1, I minus 1 will be 0. So if 2 is greater than 3, no, it is not, 2 is not greater than 3, so we will not go inside this if loop and we will continue. Okay, we will again go to I is equal to 2. Now we will go to I is equal to 2, right? So in this case what will happen is I is 5, right, and I minus 1 is 3. Okay, so this is also not true because 5 is not smaller than 3, right? I is not smaller than 3. So what will happen in this case? Again it will continue, right? So if I is equal to 3, we are at the last index now. Okay, in this case also 6 is not smaller than 5. 6 is not smaller than 5. This is also not the case, right? So we will again continue, and when we move to array.length, that means array.length here is 4. So now I will become 4. So we don't have to check here. We will come out of this loop, and when we will come out of this loop, we will return true. Okay, we will return true. That means the array is sorted. It never went into this if part, right? So let's take another example where it will pass into, like we will go into the if part. So let's say 0, 1, 2, 3, right? So let's say here we have 5, 6, 1, 7. Okay, so this is the case. So what will happen in this case? When I is 1, I starts from 1 and array dot length is 4. Okay, array dot length is 4. So 1 is less than 4. So we will go inside. We will check if arr of I is less than arr of I minus 1. That means arr of I right now is 6. 6 is less than 5. No, it is not. So we will move forward. Now I will point here. Okay, on the second index, because I before was 1, now I will become 2. In this case, what will happen? arr of i means 1 is less than 6. Yes, this is less than 6, 6 is greater, right? That means previous element is greater than the current element. Okay, so in this case, what will happen? We will go inside this part, if part, and it will return false from here. Okay, it will directly return false from here. That means the array is not sorted. Array is not sorted. Okay. So I hope this code is clear, this function is clear, how we are writing it. Okay, we have taken the examples as well, we have dry run it as well. Now let's call this from the main. Okay, this is part of DSA in Java. Okay, this is part of DSA in Java. We have already done the Java part. Okay, so now coming to how, so someone asked me that I want to know how to initialize the array in Java. So we initialize array this way, int, these brackets, okay, square brackets, arr is equal to new int 5, okay. Here we write the size of the array, whatever the size we want. New is to make the object of array, like it is, I will tell you in OOPS what are objects and everything. But you have to remember this, how to make the arrays. First of all, write the data type of whatever you want the array of, like integer array you want to make, boolean array you want to make. Then you write these boxes. Then you have this name of the array, you can give any name. Then you will have new, okay. Then you will have again the same integer here, and then the size. Okay, this is how you initialize the array in Java. Okay, now let's call the function. You are a little bit confused in functions in Java. Okay, so have you seen my lectures, like that I have already taught? So what is the confusion actually? I want to know if you have seen it. So let's first of all call this function. Okay, let's call this function. So is sorted. Okay, is sorted I am calling, and I am passing this arr. Okay, right. So first of all, let's make an array this way as well. Directly write the elements. I think I have shown you guys that we can directly make the array this way as well. 2, 3, 4, 6 and 7. Let's say this is the array I am passing is in sorted. And let's print it. Whatever it is printing, let's print system.out.print. Let's print it. Okay. So okay. So yeah. Let's print is sorted. Right. So I have called this function. I have passed this array, and it will return true or false. Let's print if this array is in sorted order. So we will print true. Otherwise, it should print false. Right. So let's run it. Let's see what will be the answer here. So the answer is true. That means this array is in sorted order. Okay. So now let's change it a little bit. So let's make it 8 here. Okay. Now it is unsorted. So let's run it again. So you can see here the answer is false. That means we have written the correct code. So now let's see what is the, sir, how to read the elements into the array which you don't know the size of the array. Sir, how to read the elements into the array when you don't know the size of the array? So if you don't know the size of the array, you know the name, right? You know the name of the array, arr. So you can directly get the arr dot length. You can get the length of the array with the help of this. If you know the name of the array, you just have to write arr dot length. Okay, is what is the use of public static before function? See, I'll tell you that this is covered in OOPS, right? This public, static, each thing has a meaning here. Public has a meaning, static has a meaning, void has a meaning. Everything has a meaning. But I will cover these things in OOPS. Okay. So, sir, geeks for geeks par jo code hota hai, kya un codes ko thoda mug up karna chahiye? That is a comment. I don't know. Give them suggestion that I want to change this code to this, then they will see it. Okay, so I don't know that much about it. Okay, so now length of 5. Okay, so now let's move forward. I think this is clear. Anybody has any doubt in this question, like how to, like is sorted part, if anybody has any doubts in it. Okay, so let me just tell you how the array is passed here. So we have this array. I pass this array to here. Okay, I pass this array here, and then I executed everything, and this function returned me answer as true or false. I have just printed it. Okay, this is how it is working. I have told in the previous class that how actually array goes, like they are pointing to the same reference, and everything that is changed here will be changed here as well, right? If you remember, in the last class I have covered all these things, how arrays work with functions. Okay, so now let's move forward, right? So next question will be, so let's see what will be the next question here. So have you guys done have you heard about the Fibonacci series? Anybody? What is Fibonacci number? What is Fibonacci series? Yes, sir. Okay. So we are going to do that, okay, with the help of arrays. I'll tell you what is Fibonacci series. We have to do that now with that. Okay. Just give me a minute, sorry. Okay. So what is Fibonacci series? So Fibonacci series is, let's say we have 0, right? So first two elements are, this is 0th element and this is first element. Okay, so these are the first two elements of the Fibonacci series. Okay, now what you have to do is, if you want to find the next element, if you want to find the second element of the Fibonacci series, how do you do that? You just take the sum of previous two. You take the sum of previous two elements and you will get the next element, okay, which is 1. Now if you want third element, if you want third element, you will get it with the help of the sum of previous two elements. Okay, 1 plus 1, 2. Okay, now if you want to get the fourth element, you will get it with the help of previous two elements. 2 plus 1, 3. Then fifth element, you will get it with the help of fourth and third element by doing the sum of them. Okay, so this is called the Fibonacci series. And you can find any element one by one like this only. You just have to know the sum of previous two elements. Okay. You just have to know the sum of previous two elements, right? So I hope this is clear. What is Fibonacci series? Anybody has any doubt in this? That first two elements we already know, which are 0 and 1. And you just have to find the whatever element. I will tell you that you have to find fifth element, you have to find sixth element, and you have to give me that element. Yeah, that should be your answer, okay? So the question is clear. That you will be given with one number only, let's say 5. You want to find the fifth element. So the fifth element of Fibonacci series is 5. So you have to return 5. Okay. So anybody has any doubt in the question? Yeah, I think the question is clear. So let's move forward. Okay. So what approach we are going to use here? Okay. With the help of array. So this also covers, like this also comes in DP also. Okay. So this, the solution that I am going to tell you guys, this is, you can say a DP solution or you can say a array solution. You can say it anyway. Okay. So let's say, first of all, what we are going to do is, okay. So let's say I have told you to find the fifth element of the Fibonacci series. Okay. I have told you to find the fifth element of the Fibonacci series. So what I will do is, what we will do is, so we will take an array of length 6. We will take the array of length 6. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. This will be the array of length 6. Okay. Why 6? When we want to find the fifth element. So the if I take only, let's say, array of length 5. Okay. If I only take the array of length 5, what will happen? It will only give me 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So the last element in this array of size 5 will be fourth index element. Okay. But what I want is, I want fifth index element, right? Here will be our answer. Here will be our fifth Fibonacci number. Okay. So this is just a beginner level. Don't worry. These are just beginner level questions. You just need to know them. Okay. These are very, very important questions on beginner level. Okay. So now what I will do is, I think this is clear. What is Fibonacci series is clear. I think this thing is clear, that if we have 0 and 1, these two elements we know initially. If we want to find any other element, let's say I say that there is a series and you have to give me fifth element of that series. okay, and that series is like this, 0 1. So if you want to find the next element, you will take the sum of previous two. Then if you want to find the next element, you have to take the sum of previous two. Then if you want to find the next element, you have to take the sum of previous two. That means 2 plus 1 is 3. So if I want to find next element, I will do 2 plus 3 which is 5. Okay, so the fifth element will be 5. You want to return this. So what I will do is, okay, so what I will do is, I will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 size of array. If I want to find the fifth element, I will take 6 size of array. Okay, because I want fifth index should also be there, because that is our answer, right? So if I want to find the fifth element in the Fibonacci series, I will take a 6 size array. Okay, and what I will do is, I will fill first two elements as 0 and 1. Okay, because I already know that 0th element is 0, first element is 1. Now, the question becomes very easy now. Very easy. What you have to do is, you have to start from 2. Okay, on the second index element, what you have to do is, let's say this, his name is ARR. Okay, so what I will do is, ARR of 2 is equal to ARR of 1 plus ARR of 0, right? So this is the Fibonacci series, that if you want to find the second element, then you have to get it with the help of the sum of previous two, right? So whatever is at the array of 1, which is 1, plus whatever is at the array of 0, plus 0, okay? So it will be 1, the answer should be 1. So the second element of the Fibonacci series is 1, right? Now same way, I can find the third element. So let's say ARR of 3, how I can find it? With the sum of previous two elements, so which will be ARR of 2 plus ARR of 3, right? So ARR of 2 is 1 plus ARR of 3 is 1, so it will be 2. So 1 plus 1, 2. So the answer of like third Fibonacci element is 2, right? Now if I want to find the fourth element, so how I will find the fourth element? ARR of 4 is equal to ARR of 3 plus ARR of 2, right? So ARR of 3 is 2 and ARR of 2 is 1. This is 2 plus 1 which is 3. So the fourth element will be 3. Now if I want to find the fifth element, ARR of 5, so it will be the sum of previous two. So we have third element sum, we have fourth element sum. So ARR of 3 plus ARR of 4, right? So this will be 3 plus 2 which will be 5. So ARR of 5 will be 5. So we have got our answer, that if I want to find the fifth element, so our answer will be at the last index of this array, which is ARR of the last index, which is 5. ARR of 5 will be our answer. Okay. So if we generalize it, you can write it this way. So let me just erase a little bit. So if I generalize it, I can write it this way only, right? So I can, if I want to find the ith element, we will get it with the help of ARR of I minus 1, that means the previous element, plus ARR of I minus 2, okay? That means the second last element, okay? So if I want to find the fifth element, that means I, if I take as 5, so it will be the sum of ARR of I minus 1 is 4, plus ARR of I minus 2, that means 3. So sum of previous two elements, right? So we have got the generalized thing, that if I want to find ARR of I in this array, we will get it with the help of ARR of I minus 1 plus ARR of I minus 2, right? And this will be, the here I will keep changing. We will start our I from 2 and it will go till the element I want to find. I want to find 5th element, it will go till 5. If I want to find 6th element, it will go till 6. If I want to find 7th, it will go to 7. Okay, one by one, I will calculate each element. Okay, now I think the concept is clear, right? I think the question, can you please also cover some medium level or hard level? Yeah, I will cover them. Just I want to clear the basics first of all. Then we will move to some medium level and hard level questions. We will do everything, don't worry. Okay, so now I think the concept is clear, how we are working around it. We have an array, we are starting from second index and we are calculating till where I want to find the element. If I want to find the fifth element, I will take the array of size 6. If I want to find the sixth element, I will take the array of size 7. Okay, I hope the concept is clear. Now let's write the code for this. And before that, just give me a minute, guys. My laptop is not charged. Let me put it on charge.
Okay guys, sorry for that. Now let's continue, right? So let's continue.
Okay, so I hope I'm visible. Now let's write the code for this, right? So now let's write the code for this. So public, let's make a function of it. Public static. Okay, so what do we want to do, sir? Oops part kaha hai, maine trees tak kar liya playlist se. See oops part I haven't done it yet. Okay, I haven't taught it yet, I will teach it afterwards. Okay, so public static, what we want to do is we want to write Fibonacci series, right? Let's say int and let's say fib. Okay, so here I will give a number, let's say n number I want to find. Okay, whichever in the series which element I want to find, I will give that in this n. Okay, let's say the n is 5. Right now I am thinking that the n is 5. Now let's move forward. What we have to do, first of all I'll make an array. Int arr is equal to new int, okay, n plus 1. Okay, one more size of array I want to take. If I want to find fifth element, the size of the array will be of size 6, right? If I want fifth element, the size of the array will be 6, because I start from 0, because indexing in Java in arrays starts from 0 and it will go till fifth element, right? Because I want to find the fifth Fibonacci number. Now what I will do is I will first of all put arr of 0 as 0, right? Arr of 0 will be 0 only, and arr of 1 will be 1, right? This is, we know that starting points are this, like 0th element is 0 and first element is 1, right? Now what I will do, just a simple thing, I'll start from 2 for int I equal to 2, I less than what, n, okay, less than equal to n, right? And then i plus plus, right? So what we are doing, same thing, I started from second index element, that means my I is pointing here, and what I will do is first of all I will calculate the second element of the series, right? Then I will move to 3, I will move to 4, I will move to 5, right? Then whatever is at the 5, because I want fifth element, I want the fifth element of the Fibonacci series, right? Because n is 5, I am passing 5. So at last, when this whole array is filled, I will just return whatever is at the fifth index of this array, whatever is at the last index of this array. Okay, so what was the generalized solution here? arr of i is equal to arr of I minus 1 plus, I will dry run it as well if any doubt, arr of I minus 2. Okay, so one by one we will go to each element and we will calculate each element with the help of previous two elements, right? This is what we are doing, and then after it we just have to return arr of n, right? The last element we just have to return it. Okay, so let me say oops part kaha hai, and trees ke baad kahan se continue karu ye arrays se, please help me. Yeah, after, see, trees you don't have to see it, I will cover it again in this series. Just focus on arrays. This DSA playlist you can start from starting. I have taken three classes before it, so you can go through them and then do this. Okay, and go for CP after completing this course. Okay, I will start with CP, not a problem. In Java I will start with CP, but we'll see after this, because oops is very big. Okay, we have to cover a lot. So now I think this is the code that we wanted to write. Okay, so now let's dry run it. Instead of 5, let's take 4 here. Let's say I want to find the fourth element of Fibonacci series. Okay, so the fourth element, let's calculate it manually first of all. So first two elements are this, second element will be 0 plus 1, 1. This is 0th element, this is first element, this will be second element, and third element will be 1 plus 1, 2, and fourth element will be 2 plus 1, 3. So the answer should be 3, right? So now let's see how we are doing it. So we have taken an array of size n plus 1. So the array of size will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? That means 5 size of array we have made. So the indexing will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Now arr of 0 I have put 0 here, arr of 1 I have put 1 here. Now I have started my loop from I is pointing at the second index, right? And it will go till equal to n, that means we will go till n is 4, so it will go till 4, right? Now 2 is less than 4, so we will go inside, and what we will do, I is, let's say I is equal to 2, so in this case what we will do, ARR of 2 is equal to ARR of I minus 1, I is 2, right? 2 minus 1 is 1 plus ARR of 0, okay, 2 minus 2 is 0. So ARR of 2 is equal to ARR of 1 plus ARR of 0, that means sum of previous two elements, ARR of 1 is 1 and ARR of 0 is 0, right? So this will be 1, sum 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, okay, sorry, 1 plus 0 is equal to 1. So second element will be 1, right? Now let's say I will move to 3, okay, now I is here, so let's write here, if I is equal to 3, what we have to do is, we have to do the same thing, ARR of 3, I is 3, so ARR of 3 is equal to ARR of 3 minus 1, which is 2, plus ARR of 3 minus 2, which is 1. That means sum of previous two elements. So whatever is at the second index element, which is 1, okay, whatever is at the first index element, which is again 1, I will just sum them and add it to ARR of 3. That means here also it will come as 2, okay, it will come as 1 plus 1, 2. Now I will move to the last element, which is 4. Okay, 4 is less than equal to 4, so we will move here as well. Okay, here what will happen again? So if I is equal to 4, we will go inside, we will see that ARR of 4 is equal to ARR of 3 plus ARR of 2, right? That is sum of previous 2. So 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, so ARR of 4 will also be 3. Okay, so we got our answer at the last index of the array. Okay, this was the answer, so we have got at the last index of the array. So we have directly returned it, that means ARR of n, n is 4, so whatever is at the fourth index, that will be returned, and which is 3. Okay, so I think the concept is clear, dry run is clear, let's test it. Okay, so instead of is sorted, let's call the fib of, let's say, what element you want to find, let's say sixth element. Okay, so what will be the sixth element, let's find it manually. So the fifth element, 0, 1, 1 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, and 3 plus 1, 5, and 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So the answer should be 8, right? Sixth element should be 8. Now let's run it, right? So we will run it and we will see if the answer is 8 or not. So you can see the answer is 8. That means we are doing the correct thing. The code is correct and it is working fine. Okay. So how many months for the course, sir? Can we go for season? So how many months for this course is going on? See, it will take time. So it will take time. I cannot tell you how much time, but it will take time because we have just started with arrays. We have to cover strings. We have to cover recursion again, searching, sorting. Then we will move to linked list and stacks, queues, trees. Graphs, DP, everything. We have to cover everything, so it will take a lot of time, but it will be a very good journey if you just go along with it. Okay, I have studied DDA as well. It's in semester 1 for IC, so I don't know what you are talking about, but yeah, so let's move forward. So these are all topics of OOPs. I will cover everything, inheritance, polymorphism, other things as well in OOPs only. Okay, so this is the part of OOPs. So now I think this question is clear. Anybody has any doubt till now, like the two questions that we have done? Anyone have any doubts? Okay, clear. Okay, sir. Yes. Okay, so let's move forward. So now what we have here is, okay, so what we have here is, let's move forward. Now let's do the next question. So the next question we are going to do here is, let's say we have, next question we can do is, so next question we are going to do is pair sum. Okay, so pair sum. So if you have heard about this, the question is that you are given with an array. Okay, you are given with an array, let's say 2, 3, 6, 1, 0. Okay, so this is the array you are given with, and you are given with a sum. Okay, sum, let's say, is equal to 7. Okay, And what you have to do is, your question is that you have to find all the pairs in this array which has sum 7. That means pairs you have to find, like two elements which has the sum 7. You have to print all those pairs, right? So okay, you have one doubt on line number 5. Just let me go to that. First of all, let me tell you the question. So if the question is clear, that you are given with an array, okay, and this array has different elements, you have to find all the pairs whose sum is 7. This is the question. So right now what you have to focus on is your how to solve the question. Okay, so two things, there are a lot of approaches to solve this question. Okay, I think some of you might know that as well. So but right now we are not focusing on time complexity, we are just focusing on building the logic. Okay, so if you guys are coming up with any solution, that is okay. Just think for a minute and let me just clear that doubt. First of all, what doubt you are having? The doubt is on fifth line, this line. Okay, so the we can make arrays in like arrays in Java two ways. If you know all the elements, you just write this way. This will make an array. Or you can write it this way as well, new array and the size of the array, and then you can just what you have to do then you can add the elements, like on array of 0 you want to add something, array of 1 you want to add something. This way you can do it. Otherwise, if you know the elements you want to put in the array, you can directly write it this way. Okay, this is how you can do it. Now coming back to the question, yeah, it is like two sum only. Yeah, the question is like two sum, or you can say pair sum, the same thing. So anybody has any approach how we can solve this question? Any approach will work. 2, 4, 3, 1, and 10. Okay, I want to find, I am given with a sum. Okay, this is an array and the sum is 10, 14, any sum you can take, let's say 6. Okay, 6, I want to find out that I want to find all the pairs whose sum is 6. Okay, so I think this is very simple. Okay, anybody, anything, any approach you are thinking about? Find subarray sum and compare with given value. Subarray, no. Okay, so what we want to do is, we are just finding the pairs. Okay, we are just finding the pairs, not the subarray or anything else. We just are finding the pairs right now. 2 plus 4, 6. Yeah, I know, I can see that. But what will be the approach to solve this question? So let me tell you. Okay, so the approach will be very simple approach. First, very naive approach that we can use here is that let's check all the pairs in this array. That means that let's say I have 2. Okay, so I will check 2 with by adding it with each element here. So I will check 2, adding it with 4. Okay, so 2 plus 4 is 6. So we have found the first pair. The first pair will be 2 and 4, right? This will be our first pair. Now I will check 2 with 3. 2 plus 3 is 5, not 6. So this is not one pair. So 2 plus 1 is 3. It is not equal to 6 as well. 2 plus 10 is 12. It is not also equal to 6 as well. So the first pair that we have found is 2, 4. Now, this is just for 2. We had the combination of 2 with every element, right? Now, I want to find other combinations as well. Let's say 4. Now, let's start with 4. 4, we will see combinations of 4 with everyone else. So I will check if 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. No. So see, this with 2, it has already covered in the 2 part. That means what I'm trying to say here is, this pair, 2, 4 pair has already been covered by 2. So I will just start from the next element. So for 4, I will check for 4 plus 3 is equal to 7. No, it is not equal to 6. 4 plus 1 is also not equal to 6. And 4 plus 10 is also not equal to 6. Okay. Now I will move forward. I will check for 3. 3 plus 1 is not equal to 6. 3 plus 10 is not equal to 6. Right. So this is also gone. Now we will come to 1. I will check 1 plus 10 is equal to 6. No, it is not. So this is it. We will just come out of the the code, and we have just printed 2 and 4. Right. So this is a brute force solution. So check one by one all the numbers, right? And when I plus I minus 1 equal to 6, print now. I plus I minus 1 equal to 6, print now. So what is this? okay, array of I plus array of I minus 1. No, 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 this will not work. So why it will not work is, see, sometimes we get confused in this. Okay, why we get confused is, so let's say we have 2, 3, 4, again, let's say 5 and 1. Okay, now I want to find the 6. We have the sum as 6. I want to find all the pips. So what you are trying to say here is that if we have I here, we just check with previous element. That means I'll just check 3 plus 2 is equal to 6 or not. Then I'll just check 4 plus 3 is equal to 6 or not. Okay, so this will not work because a lot of pairs, you will leave a lot of pairs in this. Okay, if we are, let's say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the indexing. So what will happen is if you are at second index, you are saying just check that at any ith index, that previous, just add it to the previous element and then check if the sum is 6 or not. That will not work because a lot of pairs will be left. Okay, if I just start from here, let me tell you what will be wrong here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. Okay, 0, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I'll come to two-pointer approach as well. But right now I'm just going with the brute force. We will come to two-pointer approach as well. Right. So I hope what I'm trying to say here is that for each element, I have to check with every other element in the brute force solution. And if it comes out to be 6, then it is correct. Otherwise, it is not. Okay. And how we are going to do it? I am going to do it with the help of loop inside loop. That means loop inside loop means we will fix this element. Let's say this is I and I will take j here. And j will travel on each element. So first of all, I will check I plus j, whatever is at the I and whatever is at the j. So 2 plus 5, 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. If this is equal to 6, no. So I will move my j. Okay, j will come here. Now what will happen? 2 plus 4. That means ith element plus jth element sum is 6 or not. Yes, it is 6. So I will print 2 and 4. Okay, now I will move forward. My j will move forward. And what will happen? 2 plus 5. Is it equal to 6? No, it is 7. So I will move forward. Now j will point here. So here also what will happen? J plus I, that means 1 plus 2 is equal to 6. No, it is not. So I will move forward. Okay. Same way, after doing the first iteration, my I will move forward because I have covered all the numbers with 2. Now I will move forward. 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1. Now what will happen? I will point here and J will point at I plus 1 because I want to start from next element, right? I want to see 3 with all these elements because 2, 3 has already been covered. Okay. In the previous iteration, you can see here, 2 and 3 pair has already been covered. So we don't have to start from 0. We have to start from I plus 1. J will start from I plus 1. So I will again check 4 plus 3 is equal to 6. No, it is not. So J will move forward. I will again check 5 plus 3 is equal to 6. No, it is not. So J will move forward. 1 plus 3 is equal to 6. No, it is not. Again, in the next iteration, what will happen? I will move forward 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1. So I will point here and J will be at I plus 1. Okay, same way we will check for each element. Okay, for each element, we have to check all the pairs. So how do we write the code for this? Let me write it. So let's say we are writing the code for this. Let's make a function. Okay, let's make a function. So public static void. Okay, we need to print. So we will use void and let's say two sum, right? So let's name it as pair sum. Okay, so pair sum, right? Now we will pass an array to it. We have to find all the pairs whose sum is equal to, we have to find the sum as well. Okay, we have to give the sum as well, that all the int sum, right? Now we will go inside and we will write the code. How do we write the code? So what we will do is, this is very brute force solution. So what we will do is, for int i equal to 0, I less than arr.length, you know what is arr.length? That means the length of the whole array, and I plus plus. Okay. And another loop, which is for j, int, I will dry run it as well, don't worry. J is equal to I plus 1. We will start from I plus 1. We will go till I is less than arr.length. Okay. And j plus plus. Here also j should be less than ar.length. And what we will do, we will see what I have done here. First of all, I'll tell you that. So okay, so do I have to initialize j with, yeah, you have to initialize j with i plus 1. You can see here I have done that. Okay, can we also use binary search logic, but we need to sort the array for that. Yeah, see, all the other solutions, we can take a lot. See, I have already told in the starting that there are a lot of solutions to this question. We can do it with the two sort pair sum as well. You can use binary search logic as well. But the things that I have covered till now, I will use that. And then we will move to different topics and we will again do this question with the help of that approach. Okay. Right now, I will cover two approaches. This is brute force approach. Okay. And I will also cover two pointer approach. These two approaches I will tell you right now. Okay. Now, let's move forward. What you have to do is, now, see, till now, what I have done is, I have taken an array, ARR, whose name is ARR. And here, what you have is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? And let's say the elements are 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, right? Now, I have taken my I at 0th element. You can see I have started from 0 and J has started from I plus 1, which means here. Now, what I have to check is if ARR of I plus ARR of J is equal to what? Sum. The sum that is given to us, if they are equal, then what you have to do is you have to print it. System.out.print. You just have to write ARR of I plus space plus ARR of J. Right? What I am doing here, I'll just tell you. Okay. So what I have done here, if I find the element as at ith index and the element at jth index, if I find the sum of these in both elements as equal to the sum, let's say the sum is 6 and the array is this. The array is 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. If the array is this and the sum is this, then I have to print that element. Okay. Now let's dry run it for once. Okay. So I is at 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I is at 0th element. Okay. Now what will happen? J will point at I plus 1. I plus 1 means at here. Okay. I is 0. So J will be I plus 1, which is 1. Now what will happen? We will go inside in this J loop. Okay. What I will do is ARR of I plus ARR of J. Whatever is at the jth index, which is 3, plus whatever is at the ith index, which is 2. I will take the sum of that and I will check if it is equal to sum. No, it is not. So what will happen? We will not go inside this if part. We will not print anything. Okay, so again this J loop will run until the inner loop is done running. We cannot move to the outer loop, right? So now this inner loop, what will happen? J will increase, J will move to 2, second index, right? Now what will happen? Again the same thing. I will go inside, I will check that ARR of I means 2 plus ARR of J is 4. So 2 plus 4, is it equal to 6? The sum is 6, right? So it is equal to 6. We will go inside and we will print what? 2 and 4. The first pair printed is 2 and 4. Right? Now what will happen is we will move forward. Again, this inner loop will run until the last element, right? Until ARR.length, this loop will run. Now J will point at third index. Again, the same thing will happen. We will go inside, we will check ARR of I, which is 2, plus ARR of J, which is 5, which is 7, right? So 7 is equal to 6. No, it is not. So we will not do anything. We will not print it. Okay. Now what will happen? We will move to the next element of J, which is 1. So 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 3 is not equal to 6. So this is done. That this is also not printed. Okay. Now what will happen? We will come out of this inner loop and we will go to the outer loop now, because all the elements are covered in J. Okay. Now what will happen in this case? Now my I will become 1. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. Now what will happen when my I is 1? So 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1. This is the thing. Now I is 1. So I will point here and J will point at I plus 1, which is if I is at the first index, it will point at the second index. Now what will happen? The same thing you have to do, that you have to check ARR of I. ARR of I is 3 plus ARR of J. ARR of J is 4. Okay. So this is J and the sum is 7. This 7 is not equal to 6, right? This is not equal to 6. So we will not print it. So J will move forward. This inner loop will run again. J will move forward. Now on the third index, you can see 5 plus I is 3. 5 plus 3 is 8. 8 is not equal to 6. So again, we will move forward. J will point at the fourth index. Here what will happen? 1 plus 3. I is at 3 and j is at 1. So 1 plus 3 is 4. 4 is not equal to 6. So again, this is done, that we have only printed 2, 4 till now, nothing else. Okay. Now this inner loop is done. Again, the outer loop will run. In this case, what will happen? For I is equal to 3. Okay. For I is equal to 3. Sorry, I is equal to 2. We will run it. So 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1. Okay. This is the case. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I is at this index now. And j will be I plus 1 here. Now 4 plus 5. Is it equal to 6? No, it is not. So we will, j will move forward. So 1 plus 4, is it equal to 6? No. So inner loop is done. Again, the outer loop will run. Now for I is equal to 3. Okay. So for I is equal to 3, what will happen? 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1. Okay. Now what will happen? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I is at 3 and j will be at I plus 1, which is 4. Right. So I have to check again inside that array of I and array of j is equal to sum is equal to 6. So 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. And this is equal to the sum that we wanted. So this will also get printed. So what we have printed till now, 4, 2, 4 and 5 and 1. Okay, this is what we have printed till now. And now what will happen is, again we will come out of this inner loop and this outer loop here, it will point at last index. So last index if we are pointing at, so j will be at 5, so which is out of bound, so it will not run for the last index because we have covered all the indexes. So I think this is done, right? So two things will be printed, 2, 4 and 5, 1, right? So I hope the dry run is clear to you guys, how I have dry run it, because that is very important at how the execution is going on. So now let's try to run it. So I will pass, let's change this array, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, okay? Now I will just call this pair sum and with this array, AR, okay? Now let's try to, so I think the name is pair sum and sum I have to find. So I will just give 6, okay? And we don't have to print it, so I will just remove it. Right, now let's try to run it. So when I run it, the answer is 2, 4 and 5, 1. So I think I haven't used ln here, so let me use ln here. Okay, so now it will be printed correctly. So you can see here, the answer is 2, 4, 5, 1. That we have already predicted, this should be the answer. So from where we can learn arrays in C++. See, I think the classes of C++ are also going on this channel. You can do watch them, go watch them as well. So that is the thing. And also you can go on, if you want to learn arrays, I think there is another channel of here, Code Tribe, I think. That is also a channel of an academy where I think Sanket is teaching C++, arrays in C++. So you can watch his lectures as well. They are also very good. Okay. He's a very good mentor and I think you guys will be good, fortunate to learn from it. Okay. So learn from him. So I think this is clear. Anybody has any doubt in this approach? Yeah, the time complexity for this, it will be big of n square. So I think some of you would not know what is time complexity, what is space complexity. I'll take a separate lecture on it. Okay. I'll take a separate lecture in, don't worry about that. But right now, the students who know it, so big of n square and big of one will be space complexity. So I'll tell you how we calculate time complexity, a little bit about it. So what we do is, let's say here what I was doing. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So we had some elements here, right? So what I was doing was, let's say for one element, for first element of this array, how many pairs I took? 1, 2, 3, 4, right? That means if n is the size of the array, so for 2, we have to check for n minus 1 pairs, right? We have to check for n minus 1 pairs. If the size of the array is n, and for first element, I have to check for n minus 1 pairs. 4 pairs, size of the array is 5, right? And for 3 also, what I did was 1, 2, 3. So I checked for n minus 2 pairs, right? Then for 4, I checked for 2 pairs, which is n minus 3 pairs. And for 5, I checked for 1 pair only, which is n minus 4 pairs, right? So you can say that it can go till 1. Okay, so you can see here what is written here. This is sum of n natural numbers. If you write it in opposite way, 1 plus 2 plus till n minus 2 plus n minus 1. Okay, and it also goes till n. Just take it till n minus 1. So you can see how many operations we have done. We have done sum of n natural number operations, right? So the sum of n natural numbers is n into n minus 1 by 2, right? So it n into n plus 1 by 2, okay? So this is the thing, and it is equivalent to n square plus n by 2, right? So the highest power here is n square, right? So we take time complexity as big of n square. This is just an overview how we think, like how we think that how many operations we are doing in this question, that will be equivalent to our time complexity, okay? We write it in the form of n. N means the size of the array or the number you are taking, n can be anything. Right now here, n is the size of the array. So the time complexity here is big of n square, and we are not using any extra space, right? We are not using any extra space. So the space complexity is big of 1. It is the smallest space complexity or time complexity that you can have, which is big of 1, okay? If we are not using any extra space, we write it like this, okay? So I hope this is clear. The approach is clear. Where we can find full Java course videos, okay? So you can, if you want to learn from very basic, I have a playlist on this channel only, which is I think Core Java playlist. You can see in the playlist part, you can learn from there. And if you want like just DSS, so I have started 2 classes before only, so you can go and check that out, okay? And this is the third class for DSS. Now tell me guys that if this is clear, so that I will tell you the next approach how you can solve it. Clear sir, one is clear. Anybody has any doubt, just ask me right now, like how it is working, actually how it is working, so that I can tell you how, because this type of approach usually opens the mind only, okay? Because clear sir, okay. So let's move forward, okay? Let's see the next approach, okay? So there is a one approach that we call two pointer approach, okay? So two pointer approaches, let's say we have 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, okay? Let's say this is the approach we have, okay? Right, so this is what this is our array that is given to us, and the sum that is given to us is 6, okay? We want to find all the pairs in this array whose sum is 6. Now we are going to use another approach, right? We are going to use another approach, which is called two pointer approach. So what is this approach? So we have this array. First of all, let's sort this array. Okay, let's first of all sort this array. So it will be 1. Sorting means we are putting the elements of the array in increasing order. All the elements in this array will come in increasing order when we sort it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, after sorting it, after putting it in the increasing order, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? This is the way we sort the array. And there are different techniques to solve the array, so we will study about them as well, okay? But right now just think that we have sorted it with the help of internal function arrays dot sort, okay? This will be the function we are going to use. If I pass arr here, the name of this array, in Java it will directly sort it. It will directly sort the array if we have arrays dot sort arr, okay? Now after sorting we get this array, okay? Now what is two pointer approach? So we will take two pointers. So pointers in Java, there is no pointer in Java, but we take two variables. Let's say I here and J here. Okay. Yeah, array is contiguous in Java. That is, I have told in the first class only that array is contiguous. In any language, array is contiguous. Right. So I and J. Right. So what I will do is, why I have sorted it. So after sorting the array, you can see every element is greater than the previous element, okay? Every element is greater than the previous element, right? Now what will happen? Let's say I take the sum of first element and the last element. So the sum of this will be 6, okay? So sum is 6, so we will print 5 and 1. This will be our one answer. Now, this is 6, right? We have got, by chance, we have got the first sum as 6 only. First pair we have found like this. Now let's say if it is not 6, let's say if it would have been 5, okay? Let's say if it would have been 7 here, okay? Let's say if it would have been 7 here instead of 5. So what will happen is 7 plus 1, it is 8, okay? 8 is smaller than 6, sorry, 8 is greater than 6, right? 8 is greater than 6. So what we will do is, so think it this way, that every element is increasing. If I have I reference and j reference, that means I variable and j variable, okay? So I take the sum of that comes out to be 8, which is greater than the element we are looking for. The sum that we are looking for is 6. 8 is greater than 6. So what will happen is, if I want to decrease it, if I want to decrease the value of 8, that means I want a lesser value, right? I want a lesser value. So in that case, what will happen is, just think it that way, that I want to increase I or I want to decrease j. That means if I want to decrease the overall value, if I want to decrease the overall value, which is coming out to be 8, but I want 6, right? So what should I do? Either I should decrease the j or I should increase the I. I should move j to the previous element or I should move I to the next element. What should I do? What should the option I should take to decrease this value, to decrease this 8? So what I will do is, I will just decrease the j. I will put j on the previous element. Why? Because see, we know that this array is sorted. Okay, we have sorted it. That means every element is greater. Okay, next element is greater than the previous element. That means this array is sorted. So what will happen is, when this array is sorted, okay, when this array is sorted, so in that case, what happens is, if I decrease the value, I will take j from here to here. That means my overall value will definitely decrease, because the last element is greater, so the previous element will be smaller than the last element. So when I do sum of this element and this element, that will definitely be less than the sum of 7 and 1. Okay, see, what I have done is, I is at the 0th index. That means arr of I, arr of 0 is 1, okay? And j is at the last index. Last index means 4, okay? So arr of 4 is 7. When I take the sum of both of these, it will come out to be 8, okay? This 8 is greater than 6 that we are looking for. Now what I want is, I want to decrease this overall 8 value, okay? How I decrease this overall 8 value? How I will decrease it? So if I take, instead of j is equal to 4, if I don't take the last element, if I take the second last element, j is equal to 3, arr of 3, so it becomes 4, sum will be decreased to 5, right? So sum will only decrease if I make my j point to the previous element, okay? Make my j point to the previous element, because this is the greatest element, and if I want the less sum, if I want total sum to be less than 8, I have to move my j to the previous element. For sure, because this way only, if 7 plus 1 was 8, so definitely the previous element of 7, which is anything, which is less than 7, we know, because the array is sorted. So this should be less than 7. So if I take the sum of 1 and 4, it should be definitely less than 1 plus 7, right? So in that case, that's why if we want to decrease the total sum that we are getting, then we will move our j to the previous pointer. Okay, I will decrease my j, right? Now let's just erase it and again write the thing, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 7, right? So right now I was at here and I decreased the j. Now let's take the sum. Now 4 plus 1 is equal to 5. So 5 is less than 6, right? 5 is less than 6. Now what will happen in this case? So we have to increase our j I in this case. Why? I have to put my I on the next element now. Why? Because the overall sum that we are getting is smaller than what we wanted, right? We wanted 6, but the overall sum that I am getting here is 5, right? So I want to increase my overall sum, okay? I want to increase the sum of my pair. So in that case, I will increase my I, because you know that the first element is the smallest, okay? When first element is the smallest, then next element will definitely be greater than the first element, okay? So if I want to increase my sum so that it becomes equal to 6, I want to move my I. I have to move my I, okay? So I will move my I here and I will say 2 is there. So 2, whatever is at I and whatever is at j, when I take the sum, it becomes equal to 6, right? So we have found our pair, which is 2 and 4, okay? We have found our first pair, which is 2 and 4, okay? So in this case, we have used 2, we have used 4, right? So now when we find the pair, we will just increase our i and also the j, right? So in this case, we have to stop, because if i and j either they crosses each other, that means I becomes greater than j, or I equal to j. In that case, we have to stop, right? We have to stop in that case. Okay. So I hope this concept that we are talking about is, I will write it here, what the concept is, that in the two pointer thing, what we have to do is, we have to take two pointers I and j, and we have to take the sum of the elements at the ith index and the jth index. Before it, we have to sort the array. Sort the array. We take two pointers, one I and one j. Okay. We take the sum, whatever is at the array of I and array of j. Okay. If it is greater than the sum we are talking about, if this sum is greater than that the sum we are talking about, in that case we will decrease our j. Okay. Otherwise, if it is less than, if array of I plus arr of j, if it is less than sum, okay, if it is less than the sum, then we will increase our I. Then we will increase our I. Right? Otherwise, what I will do is, else, at last, the last thing that we have to do is, I will increase my I as well as decrease my j. Both the things I will do if I find the pair. If I find my pair, I will print it and I will increase my I as well and decrease my j as well. Okay? This will be the whole approach. Anybody has any doubt, anything you want to me to explain it again, just let me know. Then I will write the code. So let me first clearly write the code, right? So that I will dry run it, then you will get it properly, right? So let me write a function here. So public. Yeah, array should be sorted for two pointers, because that's the only way. See, if the array is not sorted, so if the array is not sorted, 2, 3, 4, 1, 5. So in this case, I cannot guarantee that the first element is the smallest and the last element is the greatest. Okay. And when the sum of them is greater than the element we are looking for, if the sum of them is greater than 6, in that case, I cannot guarantee that if I decrease my j, then I will get the smaller sum. Okay, there can be a greater element here, there can be a smaller element here. But if the array is sorted, then I can definitely tell the previous element of this will be smaller than 5. And when I take the sum of both of these, that will be smaller than the sum we got from 5 and 2. Okay, this is the case. So array should be sorted in this for sure. Okay, let's write the function public static. And what we want to write is same void and pair sum pair. I will tell the time complexity of this as well. Okay, don't worry. Pair sum, and why we are using this approach? Pair sum new. Let's say pair sum new we are using here. Here we have to pass the array and we have to pass the sum. Okay. Now what I will do is, I will take, we have the array, we have the sum. Okay. Now the approach is, first thing is we have to sort the array. So in Java, if you want to sort the arrays.sort, and we need to write array here. Not is sorted, we have to write arrays dot, sorry, this has taken that function, arrays dot sort. Okay, so this should be, s should be smaller. Okay, so this is the function we have in Java. I think there is some issue. What is the issue? Let me check that. The method sort is undefined for the type arrays. What is the issue here? Okay, so I think I haven't taken that. Let me just give me a minute, guys. Let me import it. We have to import it. No, we have imported everything here. So why it is giving the error? Arrays.sort. ARR. So this is the function we have. Array. Sorry, I think this is something problem here. So arrays.sort is the function I know. Let me write it first. Okay, let me just hope that this is sorted. Okay, arrays.sorted is function. No. This is a bigger doubt. Just give me a minute. Let's check it. Okay, let's check it. Anything, if you have anytime you have doubt, just check it. Sort the array in Java. Okay, let me check it. So this is the simplest way. Arrays dot sort method. How to use arrays dot sort method? I think this is the same method I was using. Why it is giving me the error? Arrays dot sort. Okay. The arrays dot sort is, I am using the correct one. Why it is giving me the error? Okay. So the thing I am using here is correct. Arrays dot sort is the correct thing I have here. I don't know why it is giving the error. Let me just import first of all arrays. Okay. Let me just import java.util.arrays. Okay, here is the issue. Then we come in the same file. Import java.util.arrays conflicts with the type of defined in the same file. Okay, I got it. Got the error. Okay, so what is the error here is that. One important thing that you have to remember while coding is that the class you are using here, the name of the class you are using for yourself, okay, here I have used the class arrays, right? So this is wrong. Don't use the same class as the name defined in your, like, in the internal of Java. Internally the Java has already this class arrays, okay? This arrays class has this sort function, okay? This arrays class had this sort function. But right now what is happening is we have made the same name of the class arrays, okay? That's why it is not taking, picking that array class inside, which is inside the Java. It is taking this class and it is finding that if there is any function in this class, yeah, there is a name conflict. We already have an arrays in the Java and we are trying to we are making the same name class, like we don't have to do this, okay? So let me just correct it. Okay, so what we can do is we have to make a new class now, right? So let me just make a new class. It will just take a minute, just give me a minute, because we cannot use this function in this class. So let me make it in this, right? So class, let's make a new class. Let's name it array questions. Right, let's make a main function as well. So I'll just finish it. Right, we have made a new class. I'll just copy some things from that class, not much, just this. Control C, and I'll just copy this to array questions. Right, now let's make a call. Okay, let's make this pearson. Let me just do it, and let's make this new function, which is public static, okay, public static void and pearson with two pointers, right? With two pointers we are doing it. So here I will pass an array int ar, right? So now, so this way, see, this is the why this error happened, and this is because we have to learn oops what classes are, what everything is. That's why we have to learn oops. Okay, I didn't like remember it that we have the same name of it. So that's why the name conflict should not be there. Never should be there, right? So I did that mistake, very big mistake. Okay, so public static pair sum int ar. Okay, now we have to write that approach. So what was the approach? That first of all, we have to go to, we have to take two, first of all, we will sort it. Arrays dot sort. Okay, we have to sort this array first of all, ar. Again the same thing, but this time it will be done. Arrays dot sort. Okay, and here, yeah, two parameters will be there, sum and basic array. Yeah, two parameters int sum. Yeah, so now let me just import java dot util dot star. I think still there will be an error. Yeah, I knew there will be an error. Why? Because this is in the same class. Let me just delete this class. Okay, this will happen for sure. This will help us. Let me just delete this array class. Refactor. Let's rename it. Okay, let's rename it to arrays one. Finish. Just give me a second, guys. Sorry for that. Sorry for the delay. just if any time you get this error like this, just do that, like just change the name. Or what you can do is it has finished. Right, so this the name of the this has been changed to arrays one. Now we can directly go here and we can use arrays here. Right, see, now it is done. Now it is correct. Anytime if you have this type of error, you can see how I have solved it. You can rename the class, or you can make a you can rename the class, that will work. Right, so you can see I have used arrays dot sort. Now it is working. Arrays dot sort arr. I have sorted this array. Now the next thing I have to do is I have to take two pointers, int I is equal to 0 at the first element, and the last pointer will be at int j is equal to arr dot length minus 1. What I have done here, if the size of the array is 5, okay, if the size of the array is 5, so I will point at 0th index, I will point here, and j will point at the last index. Okay, last index is, if the size of the array is 5, last index will be 4, which is arr dot length, which is 5 minus 1. So I will point at 0th index and 1, 2, 3. And 4 will point there, right? Now what will happen? Now we have to use a while loop. While, and the condition where I have to stop that execution, whatever we were doing, where we have to stop if I is greater than j. Anytime if I becomes greater than j, okay, then we have to stop it, right? Wherever I becomes, I'll tell you, I will show when we will dry run it. So when I will become greater than j, we will just stop it. And if arr of I plus arr of j, okay, are greater than sum, if the sum of both the elements is greater than the total sum that I am getting here, so what we have to do is we have to decrease our j, right? We have to decrease our j. Else if arr of I plus arr of j is less than sum, okay, in this case what we have to do, we have to increase our I plus plus, right? In this case, we have to increase our I. Otherwise, else, the last part will be, else will be, we have to increase our I as well as we have to decrease our j, both the things, if we have found the pair. Okay. And one more thing, you have to remember, this approach that I am using here is, you can say 4 plus 4, it is correct. Okay. So this is a two-pointer approach. So this approach is used in many questions. Okay. So this is used in a lot of questions, because if we sort an array, the two-pointer approach is the first approach that should come into your mind. Okay. So you can take this, you can take two pointers, and you how you can increase the value, how you can decrease the value. This is very, very important approach, two-pointer approach. It is used in a lot of questions. Okay. So there is one more question, which is triplet sum. That means we have to find the, we will be given with the sum, and you have to find the three elements which has the sum equal to this sum, right? In that also, we can use the two-pointer approach to decrease its time complexity, okay? So a lot of things are there, right? So now let's move forward and let's see, this is the whole code. We don't have to do anything else. And also when you are writing it, you have to print it as well. System.out.print. Let's dry run it once. Arr of I plus arr of j, right? This is the case. Now let's dry run it. Let's take a smaller array. Okay, let's take the array of size 5 only. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Here I have, let's say I have sorted the array. Let's say I have sorted the array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's say this is the array we have, and we want to find the sum as 6, right? Let's say this is, after sorting, we have got this. Now I will be at 0. And j will be at the last element. Now what you have to do is, until I is greater than j, okay, if I is greater than j, I is not greater than j, sorry, it should be while j is greater than j. Sorry for that. See, what you have to do is, until j is greater, that means j is 4, so 4 is greater than 0, right? I is 0 and j is 4, so 4 is greater than 0, right? So we will go inside. Now what will happen is, we have to see array of I. Array of I is 1, okay, 1, and array of j is 5, 1 plus 5, which is equal to 6, right? So it is not greater, it is not less, it will go to else part, and it will print 1 and 5, and I will be increased, I will come here, and our j will be decreased as well, j will come here, okay? Now what will happen, you can see here, again the loop will run. We will see our I now has become 1, okay, I has become 1 and J has become 3, okay, Now again we have to check the same thing, that if array of I is 2, okay, and array of J is 4, so 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, again we have got the same thing, that we have got the answer. We will go to directly else and we will print 2 and 4, right, and we will increase our I and we will decrease our J, okay. See, one mistake here that you can do, okay, this is the biggest mistake that you can do, that now I and J both are pointing at second index and both have the value 3. That means if you try to take the sum of I and J, it will be 6, right? It is correct, it is equivalent to what we are looking for, but this is just one element, there is no pair, right? This is the biggest mistake that we can do, right? While J is greater than I, J is 2, right, and I is 2, so it is not greater. That's why I haven't taken equal sign here. If I take equal sign here, this will be the biggest mistake that we can do, that when I and J are pointing at the same element, that means 3, then what it will do is, it will check array of I plus array of J, so both are equal to 3 and the sum will be equal to 6. So if we take 6, okay, if we take 6 and 6 is equal to 6, that way it will also print 3, 3, but 3 is only one time in this array. So never, don't use equal to here, only we have to solve this question until j is greater, that means J is at the end of the array and I is at the nearer of the array, like starting part of the array. So when they crosses or they are equal at the same point, then we don't have to do anything. Only until J is greater, we have to keep increasing I or decreasing J. This part you have to take care of, right? So I hope this is clear how we are solving it. What will be the answer? 2, 4 and 5, 1, right? Now let's take one more example, because we haven't used J minus minus I plus plus here. Let's take a smaller example as well, one more example. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4 and 7. Let's take 7 here, the same example we took before. So I will be here, J will be here, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I will be at the 0th element, J will be at the 4th element. Now what will happen in this case is that again, J is greater than I. So we will go inside, we will check array of I plus array of J. Array of I will be 1 plus array of J will be 7. So it will be 8. 8 is greater than 6, right? 8 is greater than 6. 6 is the sum we are looking for. 8 is greater than 6. Then what we have to do? When sum is greater than the sum we are looking for, then what we have to do is, we have to decrease our J. So J will come here. Okay. Now the condition is I is equal to 0 and J is equal to 3. The condition is this now. Okay. I hasn't moved, just J have moved. Now again we have to check array of I is 1, okay, and array of J is 4. Now it is equal to 5, right? So 5 is smaller than 6, right? 6 is greater, you can see here. So this will not work, we have to move here. That means array of I plus array of J, which is 1 plus 4, which is 5, is less than 6. It's less than 6, then we have to increase our I will move here, okay? Now let me just erase a little bit so that it becomes a little clear. Now the condition is like this. Condition look like this, right? So what you have to do? Now your I is at 2, J is at 4. Now you can see I is 1, like the index 1, and J is at index 3, right? So array of, you can see here, J is greater than I, so we have to run the loop. So in this case, what will happen? Array of I, 2 plus array of J, which is 4, which is equal to 6. So we have got our first answer. It will not go to if, it will not go to else, it will directly go to else. Sorry, if else if, it will directly go to else and it will print 2 and 4. And it will increase our I and it will decrease our J. I and J will point at 3 now. Okay. Now what will happen? 3, I is 3 and J is 3 as well. So is 3 greater than C? No. So it will not work. Now our answer is only 2 and 4. Okay. Same as we were getting from the previous code. Now I will tell you the time, little bit about time complexity here as well, that you can see here that we are not going again and again to each element. You are seeing that we are going on each element only once, right? You can see here, we were here and we were here, right? In that operation, we decreased the value. So we haven't used 7 after that. Okay, when I decreased my J, this 7 will has not used after that, right? So that means we are going on each element of this array only once, not more than that. So the time complexity for this will be big O of n, because when we are at this element, we are doing big O of one work. Then we are at this element, we are doing big O of one work. On each element, we are doing big O of one work. Big O of one work means we are just checking if, else, else if, else. These all things that we are checking here are just big O of one operations. So I will take a different lecture for time complexity only. So the students who already know that what is time complexity, I'm telling this for them, that big O of n will be the time complexity here, because we are going on each element only once and doing big O of one work on each element, right? And total elements are n, so n into big O of one will be our total time complexity, will be big O of n time complexity, right? So I hope this approach is clear, how we are solving the question here. Let's run it first. Okay, let's first run it. Now a pair sum, we are passing array and 6. Okay, so let's run it and see if the answer is correct. Sorry, again the ln work that I haven't done, ln. Okay, so you can see here the answer is 1 5 and 2 4, right? This was expected with this array 1 2 3 4 5, so the answer will be 1 5 and 2 4. If I use 7 here instead of 5, okay, so in this case the answer will be 2 and 4 only, right? So let me, yeah, just clear, anybody else has any problem in this approach? Yeah, we can use hashing. Hashing is a very important part, like in any like arrays, we can use hashing as well. But we should know how to solve question with arrays only, because hashing is, we can use hashing, but it will take extra space. Okay, so we can, if we are able to solve the question with the help of only the array given to us, that is also like, that is the best thing that we can do, right? Anybody has any issues with this approach or the previous approach, anything, just let me know. Then we will do one more question. Any problem, guys? Let me know. This is a two pointer approach, and it is used in a lot of places. In the future sessions and future questions that you will do, you can use this approach in a like a lot of places. Just let me know if this is clear. Clear, sir. Okay, clear. Now let's move to the next question. I hope this is clear. Move to the next question. The next question that we are going to do is, we have done this, we have done that, and the next question we can do is, let's say, okay, so a simple question, a little bit simple question we are going to solve now, but it has a better solution. Okay, it has a better solution. So the question here is, you are given with an array, okay, you are given with an array where you have around let's say 2n plus 1 elements. That means what I am trying to say here is not 2n plus 1 elements, let's say each element, whatever is the element here, has its duplicate. Okay, every element in this array has its duplicate. That means if we have 2 here, it is, there will be a duplicate of 2 somewhere in this array. Let's say the array look like 3 2 3 2 5 1 5. That means what I'm trying to say here is, in this array all the elements will have their duplicates as well, okay, but only one element will be there which doesn't have the duplicate. Okay, which doesn't have the duplicate, which doesn't have the duplicate, and this element we have to find. How you can find it? Anybody has any solution for it? What can we do here? So we are given with an array. The question is, you are given with an array in which all the elements has their duplicate as well. So 3 has a duplicate 3, right? 2 has a duplicate 2, and 5 has a duplicate 5. But only one element is there in this array which doesn't has the duplicate, which doesn't have the duplicate. So can you guys tell me what approach you can use here. I'm giving you 2 minutes, just let me know if anybody gets anything. And the pearsum question that we have done, you can try it on LeetCode as well. There is a question called twosum, I think. Twosum. Right? Twosum name question is there, so you can try it there as well. Right? So yeah. Anybody has any approach for this? Two pointer. You can use two pointer here. So how it will help? I don't think so. So one simple question before it. Can you you guys know, right? If I am given, let's say I have this array. Let's say 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So I have this array. If I tell you guys 0, 1, 2, 3. That I want to find, I will give you one element which is 5. Okay, I will tell you guys that I want to find this 5 in this array, and wherever you find this 5, you have to return its index. Can you do this question? This is very simple. Any doubt, any problem in this question you have? That if you have an element, you are given with an array, okay, you are given with an array and an element, okay, which is 5. So what you have to do is you have to find this element in this array, and if you find this element, you have to return its index. Okay, this is the question. Two ways are there actually. One is linear search or binary search. We haven't studied about binary search yet, so we will just do it with linear search. Okay, what I will do is I will start from the first element in my for loop. I will check if this element is equal to 5. No, it is not. So I will move to the next element. I will check if this element is equal to 5, no it is not, I will move to the next element. I will check if this element is equal to 5, no it is not, I will move to the next element. Now this element is equal to 5, so I will just print its index, or I will just return its index. Okay, I hope this is very simple. Yeah, right, this is very simple. Now let's come back to our question. Just try it by yourself. If you have any doubt, ask me in the next class. Let me just do this question now. Anybody? No, two pointer will not work here, because sorting it will not work. Okay, so one simple approach you can do is, so whatever element you are finding here, let's start from here. This is a very brute force approach. What you have to do is, let's say I am on the first element. Okay, what I will do is I will check that in the whole array if its duplicate is there or not. Okay, just like the pair sum that we have done, right? In the pair sum, what we did was we took the first element and we checked the its pair with every other element, right? We check its pair with every element, other element. So what I will do is, for 3, I will check if its duplicate is there or not. So if it is there, so I will move forward. Okay. Now I will check for 2, if 2's duplicate is there or not. So there is a duplicate of 2, right? So now I will move forward. For 3, I will check that if it's duplicate or not. So we have the duplicate of 3, right? So we will just move forward, right? This way, I can solve the question, and when I will come to 1, I will not find its duplicate in this whole array. So I will just return this 1. This way we can solve this question. We can find the first and the last occurrence of the given number. First occurrence and the last occurrence. Yeah, that is also one solution. Yeah, right, you are right. That if we have the first occurrence of the number and the last occurrence. So how it will work, like, how we can find, it will just be different from what we are doing right now. So that is, I think you have done it in C++, because this first occurrence, last occurrence, we can directly find it there, right? So I think you have done it in C++. So what happens is, what we can do here is, see, one simple solution is there. I think this solution is clear, that we can go on 3 and we can check in the whole array if 3 is there or not, right? We have 2, we can check in the whole array if 2 is there or not. We can 3 again, we can check if another 3 is there or not, for 2 as well, for 5 as well. When we will come to 1, we will check in the whole array if the 1 is there or not. If 1 is there, we will not do anything. If 1 is not there, we will print 1. Okay, this is the one solution. Another solution, Okay, another solution is very, very simple. Very simple. See, I'll tell you that we can use XOR operation. XOR. So if you know what is XOR is, so if we have, let's say 1 and 1 or 0 or 0, okay, XOR is a binary gate, you can say, or you can say is binary operator. Okay, it's a binary operator. I have covered this in my Java part, but I will tell you again. So this is a binary operator. So what happens in this is, so if we have bit like 1 and 1, okay, it will give us 0 as the answer. If we had 0, 0, it will give us 0 as the answer. If we have 1, 0, it will give me 1 as the answer. And if we have 0, 1, it will give me 1 as the answer. What is this 1, 1? What is this 0, 0? These are bits. So normally, in a short term, what I'm trying to say here is, if we have two numbers, let's say 3 and 3, if I take XOR of them, so it will give me answer as 0. Okay. Again, if I take, let's say 2 and 0, another like two different numbers, if I'm taking, the answer will be the answer will be 2. Okay. This is what I'm trying to say here. So what I can do is, if we have the same numbers, both numbers are same, the answer will be 0. If the both numbers are different, the answer will be the bigger one. If we take the XOR of 2 with 0, then the answer will be 2 only, right? So you can see in this question, this has become very simple now. So what you can see is, you can do 3. If you take all the elements of this and we just XOR them, all the elements, we just XOR them. So what will happen is 5, 1, 5, right? So what will happen is 3 will be cancelled with 3, it will become 0, right? 2 will be cancelled with 2, it will become 0 again. 5 will be cancelled with 5, it will become 0 again. Only 1 will be left. And you know, 1 when done XOR with any other element like 0. So 0 XOR 0 will be 0. And 0 XOR 1 will be 1. Now 1 XOR 0 will be 1 only. You can see here, 1 XOR 0 is 1. So you can see here, we have got our answer, which is 1. Right? And we don't have to use any loop. One loop we have to use. Other than that, we don't have to use a double loop here. Okay, so this type of question that I am telling here right now is that we have an array 2, 3, 2, 1, 3, 5 and 5. Okay, this type of array is given to us. And if there are duplicates, okay, if there are duplicates here, okay, so these duplicates will be cancelled out. These duplicates will be cancelled out. This duplicate will be cancelled out. 5 and 5, 3 and 3 and 2 and 2. Only one will be left. If we take XOR of all the elements of this array. Okay, so the answer will be 1 only, right? So this question, I think, is asked in a lot of interviews. Not interviews, I'll say, in most lot of tests that you give of any company, because people don't think like in this solution, you need to know this solution to solve this question, right? If you want to solve this question in because of n time, then you need to know this solution that you can do XOR of all the elements, right? So these types of questions are those questions that I was telling in my webinar that you have to know. Okay, before doing it, you need to know what solution you can use in this question, right? So now let's try to do it. What you have to do is very simple. Let's do it. Array questions. Let's make a class. Okay, so public static int, and what you have to do is, the question was duplicate. Okay, duplicate, remove duplicates. Right, and what you have to do is, we will get an array, arr int of arr, and what you need to do here is, you just have to take this array. Okay, we'll take an integer, let's say x is equal to 0 here, and what we will do is, for int I equal to 0, I less than arr.length I plus plus, and what I will do is, I will do x and XOR x, sorry, x is equal to x XOR, okay, x XOR arr of I. Okay, so what I am doing is, whatever is in this x, I will just XOR it with every element of I. So what will happen, let's try run it. So one doubt should be there, that there it should be 1 or 0. Okay, let's take this array 2, 3, okay, 2, 2, 3, 3, 1. Let's say this is the array. So what will happen is, when we do 0 XOR 2, the answer will be, I will start from here. Okay, the dry run looks like this. X is equal to 0 XOR 2, right? So the answer will be, when we do 0 and 1 XOR, the answer will be 2 only, right? So the answer will be 2. Now I will move to the next 2. In this case, what will happen? 2 XOR 2 will be 0, right? 2 XOR 2 will be, now when I will move forward, 2 XOR 2 will be 0. Now we have 0 in X. Now again, we will get 3. 0 XOR 3 will be 3. Okay. Now when I move to this another 3, so this X will become X. 3 XOR 3 will be 0 again, right? So now 0 XOR 1. 0 XOR 1 will be 1, right? So now in X we have 1 as the answer, and we will just return it. We will just return it. Return X. Okay, we will just return X, and let's try to run it if we are getting the correct answer. So we have removed duplicates, right? We just have to system. If you don't know about XOR, you can see my video or you can find it on net as well, or how it is work if you want to know more. Okay, so ARR, I will pass remove duplicates, remove duplicates, and we will pass ARR here. Okay, and we will see if the answer is correct. And I will take, let's say, 2, 3, 2, 3, and 1. Okay, so now let's run it. And we can see the answer is 1. Okay, you can see the answer is 1 only. So let's say another element is there, instead of 1, let's say 5 is there. So the answer will be 5, right? We have got the element which is only one time, and other elements are of two times. Okay, and order doesn't matter. You can see here, order doesn't matter. You can have any order. In any order, you can find the elements. Okay, so I hope this is clear, right? This XOR approach is clear. Anything else, whatever we have done today, I think all of the things are clear to you guys. Any doubt, just ask me right now. Any doubt? This was a 2-hour session and we have done a lot of questions, like basic questions, some different approaches, a lot of things we have done. Any doubt, guys, in the whole session, just ask me. Or is it clear? Everything is clear? No doubt? Okay. Anybody else has any doubt? No, sir. Okay. I think everything was clear. User input for array. See, I have already explained it in my first video, or this, like in the last two videos, I have explained it. Okay. So you can go and check that. Okay. I have explained a whole how to take input of the array. I have explained it. So you can check my previous two videos and you will get it. Okay, so don't worry about that. And if there is no doubt, let me just do it. So I think there is no form today. Otherwise, you guys can fill the form as well. Okay, so just one thing, just join this community so that you can get all the updates that are going on here. And also just go like, share and subscribe, because this is very, very important. And tell your friends as well. Okay, that they can also subscribe. In only 1 hour? Why, Vaishnavi? You want only 1 hour class? Why? Because I take class of 1 hour on Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, right? From 8 to 9. On Saturday, Sundays, we take class of 2 hours, right? Today we have taken a 2 hour class, and tomorrow also we'll take a 2 hour class. Anybody has any doubt, you want to ask any questions, just 4-5 minutes I have, I can take the questions as well if you guys want. Any question you want to ask? Okay, so yeah, it is a little bit difficult sometimes to manage my full-time job and also teaching, but I like teaching. Okay, because teaching is something I do part-time. I have done it in Geeks for Geeks as well. There I was a mentor as well as SDE. So here when I got into a new company, okay, in a new company, so I thought that I can manage both. Okay, you just have to schedule it accordingly. Like on Saturday, Sundays, you can take lectures, you can take 1-1 hour sessions on the weekdays as well. So you have to schedule, right? Then only you will be able to do it. Which questions on arrays for companies? Placement is going on. Okay. Which questions on arrays? So what type of placements you are looking for? Actually, that is my main question. If you are looking for, like, you just want a placement, so what we are doing here and we will do tomorrow, those questions will be enough. Okay. And you can go on LeetCode, you can get some questions, like where you can do it. Some questions you can, easy part you can do it. If you are looking for a very good company, then I think you have to go and do some medium level and hard level. Like medium level will be enough. Medium level questions of LeetCode. Okay, just try to do that. Yeah, Pranav, the session is over. So if you want to get this session, like want to watch this session again, you can just go and watch it. It was a 2-hour session. Okay, it was a 2-hour session. So you can watch it. Right now the session is over. Anybody has any questions for 2-3 minutes, I can take it. Anything else you want, you guys want to ask? And tomorrow also at the same time we will have the session, like from 8 to 10. Tomorrow also we will have the session. So can you explain about interface, please? Interface, see, I can explain about interface, but I think right now is not the right time, because you have to know a lot of things as well, like inheritance and what is abstraction, like abstract classes, what is interface, and a lot of other things, how you can use that interface. So all these things will be covered in OOPS classes, right? OOPS is a very big topic, and we will start from very basic. What is class? What is object? What is polymorphism, interface, and inheritance, abstraction, all these things will be covered in that. But I have to go sequence wise, right? I cannot just tell you interface, because you will not be able to get it, right? So let's just close the session if there is no more questions, right? So let's thank you everyone for joining in. We'll meet tomorrow. Okay. See, if Unacademy says I have to stop, so I cannot do, right? It's their channel. I cannot tell them that I have to go for the whole course. If they say that you have to stop it, so I have to, right? So that's why, don't worry, I'll try that. I will just cover all the things. Okay. So I will not stop it. If it is in my hands, it will be in my hands. I will not stop it. Don't worry. Okay. So thank you everyone for joining in. Let's just end the session now. We'll meet tomorrow, right? At the same time from 8 to 10. Okay. Thank you everyone.